so Eric is coaching student. Eric, what do you do?
I do shuttle services.
Shuttle services?
Yes.
A very, very competitive business, correct?
Yes.
How competitive is it?
It is too much to the point that I felt like I wanted to quit because everybody's just doing it, so yeah.
They say in America, every Tom, Dick, and Harry thinks they can have a car and transportation.
Yeah.
Tell us your life before coaching, before your business before coaching, and tell us about now. Because you've actually utilized my techniques, which I'm sure you'll talk about,
yes,
in the transport business, and it's amazing.
Yes.
It's like it's becoming a networking mobile.
Yes, I mean, I think my life before, I was frustrated. I had only two vehicles, and I worked with an event in Cape Town, and the first one, I mean, I filled the form, they couldn't pick me. I went to the second one, where they picked me up, and I had to go to the mastermind, and then JT was on the right brain, whatever. So, and then, how it changed that, they said they would actually brand me as a JT Foxx driver, and then that, in the first place, it did not happen. And then I complained.
Great.
I complained. They gave me a coach who I don't think he was good. And then I don't think he was good. The guy actually didn't have to, he resigned. I think he was with us for the two sessions and then he resigned. So and then I went to Damien. I complained. Said, look, this is what they promised me. And then I'm not getting anything. Damien, he took the decision right to the day. And then he just had to tell the guys who are doing the bookings that they could be able to use me. And then when JT Foxx came, and then I could be able to drive them around, and it was so good that a lot of guys, I mean, there are guys who have got ports, there are guys who have got food. So I had food, but then I did not have much ports. So some guys, they came with their big vehicles that I would be able to use, and then I would be able to combine the food and the ports together. And then I would be able to save them because I don't have a big vehicle. So, and then now when he comes to Cape Town, when he goes to interviews, I mean, he will tell you what I did. I mean, the man that he introduced me to everything that he did, I mean, wherever he goes, I mean, to the meetings, then he will be able to introduce me to people that are there, so that I can be able to be branded. And suddenly, he shared me, and I posted a piece on the Facebook, and then he liked it, and then said something. I got more than 200 friends from America, whatever. They asked for friendship, and then I would accept. And then, so yeah, that's how it happened.
I'll tell you something about Eric strategic. So he was very smart because he was driving me around, and he'd actually come to the meetings. And I normally wouldn't have my transport guy come with me, but he's family. And the thing about Eric, always on time, because I was having problems. I was showing up at the airport, and the person was there, that pisses me off. If my flight's early, I don't care. You follow, you track it, and it's not like waiting around. So Eric is at almost that first time. I go, and he goes, JT Foxx, world's number one golf coach. He has a sign. Everyone was around waiting. So when I came in, I was like, why is everyone waiting? What's wrong? And I figured out after the sign. So he had a whole crowd. So I was like, don't do that. So then he goes, Mr. X.
Yeah, but then the success, I think Jason, what he said I must create wow factor in whatever I do. And also he said I must start to go to companies and I can offer them free services and they see what I do, then they can be able to use me. And I did that. It worked. I got one big client that I'm still having it now. And the wow factor, for example, when they came, the team they came, I went into their Facebook profile over on the internet and check what they do, and then every client who was in the vehicle, then I will write something good about them that they posted last year or whatever on Facebook, and then I'll put a chocolate and then I'll give it to them. When they open and said, oh, how do you know that I was doing this? I said, no, I read and checked, you know. So yeah, that's
so now it's what you're bringing that relationship. Yeah. TV on one of these shows of SABC. So it was like really early, thinking about 5 a.m. So I'm about to go to TV. And I've done this many times, so I'm like, whatever, you know. There's like a dog walking around in that show. So I was like, you know, everybody's dressed in like jeans and I'm wearing a suit. So I was like, all right, I don't really fit in, but it doesn't matter. And so I'm about to go on air, and Eric goes, JT, 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 look at these questions. producer and ran to me. Look, they're sandbagging. And I went, what? So I went to him, and had he not told me, I would have sandbagged on live TV. They're like, things that, the lawsuit that didn't let out, all that stuff, but it doesn't matter. It's bringing up negativity.
Yes.
He stopped
and that. I must say, once we spoiled that, they did not ask him anything related to
that. Nope. Well, so, because I was able to say, hey, what the hell's going on here?
Yeah.
Like, this bullshit, I don't know. Because some researcher doesn't know. You know how people are. Eric saw that strategically. And for him, to take it from the producer and run over to him.
Yeah.
Right? And it's funny because I'm leaving, and the host is like, yeah, I'm with JT. Yeah, so I'm talking to him. And next thing you know, he's Twittering and things like that. So Eric's done a very good job at using the connection with JT Foxx, delivering well service, adding the personal touch.
Yeah.
So if you said to me, the transport business is, it's like everybody else. What he did is he added the wow factor and he had the relationship. Another thing, Eric, you live in Cape Town, a lot of you flew from across the country. You didn't say, oh, I can't come today because I have to go to Cape Town. I have to go to Joburg and I have to fly and things like that. You took initiative.
Oh, in fact, why I'm here is that I'm here for the business as well. Jason.
You were looking good.
Yeah.
You were looking good. I'm giving that compliment. Jason. I'm not here because of that.
What Jason did, the guy who was here, my partner,
Oh, you're opening a business in Joburg?
Yes, here in Joburg, transport, VIP transport. So Jason, who will put that together and then we will see.
And for the record, Jason is your coach.
Yes, Jason is the coach. Crazy.
He's reprimanding.
Oh, yes, crazy.
That's
fine. So, just
so, does coaching work?
Yes, it does, I must say. Very well.